ribbit to all. Last time we reached the last common ancestor of all living birds. The time when he lived is set to 120 or 110 million years ago. The only hint for this ancestor is in the gene of living and some fossil birds. In the same way, it's possible to find out the age of different bird groups. The first big division happened immediately after the last common ancestor. This is not meant to believe that the ancestor was a solitary bird, but the gene pool of a bird species. The beginning of a new species is always not a single entity, but a larger group of them. Geographical separation is helpful to form new species. The need to adapt to a new environment starts the motor of evolution. In case of the birds, in the beginning, about 120 million years ago, the birds split into two groups. The main difference between these groups is the jaw skeleton. The smaller group is called the Paleognathae, the larger group the Neognathae, or in modern language the old and the new jaw. In some way it's meant that the Neognaths are more progressive, maybe a reference to the way of thinking of the Victorian society. This time I speak about the Paleognaths, the old jaws. Today they are known in form of running birds, birds who have lost the ability to fly. We will see that their ancestors had the ability to fly, and in later parts we will get to know other running birds from different Neognath groups. Less is known about the first Paleognaths, and the first events are very uncertain. We find two splitting events, one about 103 and the other 98 million years ago. The temporal location is an assumption of scientists. The species are part of the so-called Lidhornis group. But the so-called Lidhornidae lived later, after 62 million years ago in the Paleocene and the early Eocene. These are more ghost paths, but not the last. Very uncertain are the Cretaceous traces. There exist no fossil remains except of petrified eggshells and maybe embryos. But it's difficult to say if these eggs are from early birds or other theropods. The ending Oolithus means that the fossil is a petrified egg, not the name for a species. Possible Paleognathae eggs are found after 85 million years ago. The first certain event is the split of the Paleognathae into the Struthioniformes and the Nothopaleognathae. This happened, according to the molecular clock, about 80 million years ago. The Struthioniformes is the ostrich group, the other group are the southern Paleognaths. 9 million years later, the Reformes split from the Nothopaleognaths. This is the group of the South American Rhea. But I think the rest Nothopaleognath groups lived in South America too, and so the division may happen there. To reach South America from Europe or Africa, it was necessary that these birds was able to fly. These other Nothopaleognaths split 2 million years later, about 69 million years ago, into the Dromaeomorphs and the Noviaritaitae. The Noviaritaitae, the new ratites, split 66 million years ago in the groups of the Casuariformes and the Struthioniformes. The first group contains cassowary and emu, the second the kiwi and elephant birds. It's also the time of the meteorite impact, the fifth mass extinction at the end of the Cretaceous. It's hard to say why birds survived, and according to the ghost paths we can count about 9 different species surviving the disaster. This means that there was much more species who not survived, but these lost birds are much more ghostly. The next event happened in the early Paleocene, about 62 million years ago. The young group of the Struthioniformes split finally into kiwis and elephant birds. The base of this date are DNA comparisons from living kiwi and fossil elephant birds. Because they died out in historic time, it was possible to get their DNA. The knowledge of the genetic family tree led to a new organization of the Paleognath cladogram. Before this, it was assumed that moa and kiwi are one clade, and maybe the elephant bird derived from ostriches. At this time the first certain fossil traces are found. The oldest fossil Paleognaths are Lidhornis and his relatives. The Lidhornidae was similar to modern tinamous, but had more evolved wing bones. This means that these Paleognaths had fully flight ability. Fossil traces of the different Lidhornis species was found in North America and Europe. 58.5 million years old are the first fossils of recent Paleognath groups. Remiornis, a bird with the size of a modern rhea, lived in France and is the first fossil representative of the ostrich group. Diogenornis lived contemporary, but fossils was found in Brazil. The 90-centimeter tall Diogenornis is part of the Rhea group, but has ancient characteristics, like larger wings, and the beak was narrow like the beak of lithornithids, cassowaries, and tinamous. This suggests that the ancestors of the Rhea and tinamous flew to South America. About 55 million years ago, the Dromaeomorphi split into Moa and Tinamou. I think this happened in South America, and the Moa group migrated to New Zealand. Maybe the Moas followed the path of the kiwi and elephant birds. And not unlike them, the relationship between the extinct Moa and the South American Tinamou was revealed by genetic analysis. Because the last Moa died out about 400 years ago, it was possible to receive their DNA. The most fossils from early Eocene derive from lithornids like Lithornis, Pseudocrypturus, and Paracathartes. About 48 million years ago, their traces vanished, sharing the destiny of millions of other species before and after them. 500,000 years later, the first fossil trace of the second representant of the ostrich group is coming in form of Polyodus. This bird, a meter height, was discovered in the famous Messel pit in Germany. The skeleton reveals the relation to the ostriches, but also basal characteristics like a narrow beak and more developed wings. But Polyodus was just a running bird and lost his flight ability. The next fossil representant, Eleutherornis, lived between 40 and 36 million years ago in Switzerland and France. This 1.5 meter high bird seems to be misplaced in the ostrich group, but it's more likely that he is part of the Ferus racidae, the terror birds. However, Eremopisus, who lived between 34 and 28 million years in Egypt, was doubtless an struthiomorph and reached a height of 2 meters. The contemporary Procerioves from England seems to be closer related to Eleutherornis, and so he is not part of the ostrich group. About 30 million years ago, the next genetic dated event happened, the separation of emu and cassowary. 2 million years later lived Emu arius, an extinct sideline within the emu group. Emu arius had a couple of cassowary-like and emu-like characteristics. Emu arius died out about 12 million years ago. About 23 million years ago, the first fossil traces of the genus Rhea was located, mostly in Argentina. A couple of related, but today extinct species, shared their habitat with them. The first subspecies of the ostrich lived about 20 million years ago. The ostriches was first spotted in Namibia, but spread out to Africa, Eastern Europe, and Asia. They reached just China. The first fossil kiwi relative, Protapteryx, lived 1 million years later in New Zealand. Protapteryx is much smaller than a modern kiwi, and the characteristics are closer to the flying ancestors. Some scientists are convinced that Protapteryx itself was a good and active flyer. However, in the next some million years, the kiwis lost their flight ability. 17.5 million years ago, the first representant of a recent tinamou species lived in Argentina. The tinamou are small, nocturnal birds with moderate flying abilities. 1.5 million years later, the first representant of the Rhea sideline Opisthodactylus lived in the south of Argentina. This genus survived till the early Pliocene. 15 million ago lived the first known fossil possible relative of the elephant birds, Psondibornis in Namibia. In the same time, there are a lot of traces of ratite eggs. The birds who are not fossilized themselves are known as Diamantornis and Namornis. The oldest ostrich genera lived in Namibia too. About 7 million years ago, a couple of fossil species existed in South America. Four species of the Rhea group shared their habitat in Argentina: Rhea, Hinosuri, Heterorhea, and Opisthodactylus. Aside of them lived several tinamou species, two of them was found as fossils in this period. In Eurasia and Africa lived a couple of ostrich species. A new group of the ostriches emerged in the beginning Pliocene, about 5 million years ago. The name of the group is Pachystruthio. The Greek word means a fat ostrich, and especially the in the year 19 discovered Pachystruthio dmanisensis, who lived on Crimea, was a very heavy giant. With a height of 3.5 meter and a weight of 350 kilogram, this creature was impressing. The three species of Pachystruthio lived in Eastern Europe and was the largest birds of the Northern Hemisphere. Other new birds of this time was the emu in Australia and the tinamou Rovereternus. Rovereternus didn't survive and vanished 2.5 million years ago. The decline of the most rare species came between 4 and 3 million years ago. After this time only the species rhea survived. It's notable that this happened half a million years before the Great American Interchange. A better destiny had the ostriches, the time between 4 and 2 million years was definite the highlight. Never before or after this period ostriches was so diverse and widespread. Contemporary in New Zealand emerged the moa and in Nova Guinea the first fossil species of cassowary. It was the time of gigantism too, with Pachystruthio, moa and elephant bird lived a lot of oversized running birds. Rhea didn't benefit from the Great American Interchange, but the tinamou was able to reach Central America and Mexico. This seems to be the last big wandering of paleognaths. All three species of the Tinamini group reached the northern subcontinent, but no one of the sister taxon not Hurini. The decline of the ostriches begun about 2 million years ago, including Pachystruthio. The habitat of the ostriches was now reduced to Africa and one exception in China. Maybe the beginning ice age was not the best climate for them. Sondobornis vanished half a million years before. But the age of giant running birds continued in New Zealand and Madagascar till historic time. There's less doubt that the reason for their extinction was the arrival of a new mammal. The settlement in Madagascar begun about 500 AD, New Zealand was one of the last settled place and the Maori landed at about 1280 AD. About 200 years later the moa was eradicated. Today live two species of ostrich and rhea, one species of emu, three species of cassowary, five species of kiwi and 48 species of tinamou. When we look at the variety for a long period we can recognize two waves, the first in the Paleocene and Eocene, the second in the Miocene. It's difficult to see a trend, but it seems that the peak has been reached between 5 and 3 million years ago, in the great time of the ostriches. An interesting aspect is the wandering of the paleognaths. The ostrich group lived first in Europe and reached Africa, where they live today, later. The sister taxon, the southern paleognaths, migrated to South America. There they split into the rhea group and the dromaeomorphi. To give an impression of the size of a couple of living and fossil birds, compare the man within the birds. The dromaeomorphi split into the novaratites and a group first remaining in South America. This group itself split into two divisions, one leads to the moa in New Zealand, the other to the South American tinamou. Deinornis robustus, the South Island giant moa, was maybe the largest bird ever. Can you recognize the tinamou in this comparison? The novaratites finally split into the cassowary and emu line in Australia and Nova Guinea. The sister taxon of them, the Struthionomorphi, split into the kiwi in New Zealand and the elephant birds in Madagascar. Epiornis maximus was a large and heavy-billed bird, maybe the heaviest bird ever. The sister taxon, Mullerornis, reached only the half size. But really small was the Propteryx. The following animation visualizes the wanderings of the different paleognaths, beginning with Lidhornis and following the path to ostrich, rhea, tinamou, and the birds of Madagascar, Australia and New Zealand. Two factors are helpful, for first the early paleognaths are able to fly, and for second they use the Antarctic continent to support their journey. But how is the state of these birds today? First we have a look to their habitats. These are reduced to Africa, South America, Australia, and New Zealand. Some kiwi habitats are extremely small, especially in the southern island. But how endangered are they really? To give an answer it's necessary to consult the IUCN Red List. This list contains different categories, representing the grade of threatening. In the category NT, what means nearly threatened, are the greater rhea, the northern brown kiwi, and seven tinamou species. The next worst step is VU, what means vulnerable. Here we find six tinamou species, the Somali ostrich and the remaining four kiwi species from the southern island. Worse is the state of the dwarf tinamou, this bird is really endangered. The worst category is X, what means extinct. Extinction of species are a normal process of nature, but in some cases the cause for their eradication was the man. Three local emu species vanished in the 19th century, and the last Arabian ostrich was seen 1966, but this was a death specimen. Moa, an elephant bird, was eradicated between the year 1000 and 1500. In summary, we see the worst situation is those of the kiwi, followed by rhea and tinamou. The emu has the largest amount of extinct species but is not threatened at all. The emu is the only one bird who won against humans in a war. I hope these wonderful birds will survive. We cannot stop every extinction, but we can improve the conditions of their life. Think the greatest problem is the human overpopulation. Whether humans need space, they ignore the claims of plants and animals. Animals and plants are forced to live in strange habitats like cities, but this is only suitable for opportunists. It's time to wake up, have a good time. Your Archibald Froggy Frog. Thank you.